this is my Dayan Hexadecagon. There's an incident a while back where somebody scrambled it and jumbled the pieces together in ways that caused it to jam and basically become unsolvable. And, while I could have probably kind of gotten it back in shape that way, I was kind of curious what the mechanism looked like, and it's actually kind of interesting. Looks like some of the old models of Earth that they used to show back in elementary school. So this fits here. And, some of the centerpieces don't reach to the core, which I find interesting. And some of, all of the hexagonal centers reach to the core, and they all have tensionable strings. So I think a, good start would be, got the pieces kind of organized in a way that makes sense. So I'll just start putting a few in there and go from there. Now you can get a sort of parity error on this puzzle, just because of the design of the pieces. And there's duplicates of pieces, and that's where the parity comes from. In particular, sometimes you'll end up with a situation where you have two edges that are out of place, and if you know anything about these sorts of puzzles, two edges out of place is normally an impossible case. There's also mirrors of every corner, so it might look like, you know, it's a yellow, red, and green, but that's not the right yellow, red, and green. And normally it's frustrating while you're solving the puzzle, now it's just, same problem. There we go. Now one of the backwards pieces, because I sorted them, because I thought I'm going to run into a problem where I need them to be the other way, so all of the pieces that didn't fit by one of them are in the same place. That's going to be a problem. Now the centers do have an orientation. Have been disastrous. If you're curious about the geometry, and I call this a hexadecagon, which is the name that it's sold under, but geometrically speaking, that's not what this is. I don't really think a hexadecagon describes any actual shape. What it is a part truncated icosahedron. Or when it's assembled, it is. Now it's what we call in the mathematics a jumbled mess. Figuring the orientation of the center pieces is difficult. It's not going well. Alright. So I done messed up a little bit here. So I thought some of the... It didn't make sense why some of these pieces didn't seem to fit. And in fact, they don't fit. And this is what happens when you jumble the cube. Or not really a cube. When you jumble one of these puzzles, because this top side is slightly smaller than the bottom side, and it'll fit better one way over the other. These hexagonal pieces are meant to have a fixed orientation, and when you throw that out of alignment, the more I look into this puzzle, the more complex it is. For as simple as it is to solve, at least with my approach, your mileage may vary, but I solve this very slowly, just because I find it. Finding the stickers that I'm looking for on the pieces in the right orientation just takes so long. Like you can see, even with the thing disassembled like this, it's taking a while. Somewhere it shouldn't be. No. Doesn't exist anywhere else. But that doesn't fit. Like I said, I'm sure there's a way that you can, unjumble it without disassembling it. So, I mean, there has to be, because it starts unjumbled. There we go. It starts unjumbled. You make it jumbled without disassembling it. So, there's got to be some way to put it together without disassembling it. That... Someone else can find that method. I will pass. Curious how I know where these sensor pieces go? I don't. But I do know that you never see red intersect red. So it must go here. And this green cannot go there because it intersects green. So it must go here. This green must go here. There should be a yellow. Yellow. Yellow doesn't intersect. Yellow. Yellow goes over there. It's basically like a big Sudoku. But this would yellow be hitting yellow. Which means that one of these is wrong. This green is wrong. This green goes here. Can't go there. This green goes there. Yellow goes here. What's left? Red. Red. Red goes there. Because, just kind of guesswork to put that together there. And I'll put that in. The edge pieces that go on the pentagon sides don't have any preferred orientation. Or they don't have any preferred permutation. But because of this difference in the top and bottom, that means that each of these hexagonal edges can only go in one place. And I don't know why I just put that there. It goes up here, but I'll leave that for last. I wasn't thinking. The pentagonal edges, you can change the orientation of them easily. Actually, I don't want to do that first. That one's this first. But it doesn't go that way. This one. Go over here. As you saw earlier, multiple identical corners that have no preference for location. Which means you can put them wherever you like, as long as they have the right color scheme. I don't know why I thought that went there. Thank you. I'm in a bit of trouble now. I seem to be missing a piece. Somehow this got where it's not supposed to be, too. I looked all around the floor here. I don't want to see it. So, I think I might be in trouble. I'm just going to put all of like, and hope that, I'm looking right at it and not seeing it, because that happens more often than I would like to admit. That and trying to find that one word I can't think of half the time without just kind of waiting 2 hours when it loads. Table here. I wonder where it could have gotten to. Alright, so the fact that I can't find it anywhere means that there's a slight chance I may have put something else together wrong. So I'll keep going, and that will tell me what it was. Trial by error. You know, why don't I just do the smart thing and count how many corners there are left, and that'll tell me if that's even a right usage of my time. 1, 2, 3. One, two, three. All right, I'm going to try it again because I lost count. Alright, now that ain't right. Something is in here wrong. I'm not sure what that is. Alright, so that is 14. I have exactly the right amount, so I put something together wrong, and I'm not sure how to figure out what that is. Because I can't really switch these two. Can't put those. Can't switch these. Alright, now I could. I could put red here, and green there. Green couldn't hit that, so I'm just gonna go with the first idea and keep assembling until I figure out where I went wrong. I think that's gonna be the easiest approach. Because if I can't figure it out with my head, I'll just have it blatantly shown to me when it doesn't work. No, we can never have things work smoothly or as planned. That just doesn't happen. Oh. Wait. Is that this or this? Well, it wasn't this. that settles it then. I'm definitely missing a piece. Get it as assembled as I can, and then I'll continue the hunt for it. Okay, so I must have put something in wrong somewhere. By the looks of it, I put a few things in wrong. I know I did something wrong, because I don't have any more of these, and counting them, I have exactly the right amount. Second, this is all that's left of the blue, yellow, and red corners, and obviously, that's the wrong orientation. This is the only one that's left of that, and it's in the same orientation. So, that means that one of the centers was put in backwards, or needs switched around somewhere, which I suspect would be this yellow and this green, because that won't intersect anything. So I'm just gonna take this. Why am I doing it this way? But I have to take these edges and corners out anyway. I'll just swap this. Swap that. That was. I want this here. This ought to work. Much nicer. Now, since most of the corners are all the same orientation, I don't really need to worry about it quite as much. Though I do think that there's one that's going to show up that's going to not be just the first one I pick. Something else is wrong now. Or one of my edges got mixed up. Get lazy, don't get mindless. Getting sloppy when you approach the end of the projects. Just makes more mistakes and it takes more time towards the end. No, I called it. Goes here. So I want blue, green, and red. This one. No. This one. There's no red and green. Which means that I have more disassembling to do. To swap these two around. That should do the trick. Beast. Yeah, alright. Now, if you ever think somebody's cheating by taking one of these apart, I think it's easier to do that than it is just to solve it in the first place. You'd be very wrong. Because I've solved one of these a couple of times. And I can tell you, is the same difficulty. At least so far. If you're interested, leave a comment down below asking to see my solve method for this. And I'll, if I get enough comments of that, then I'll post a video on how I approach it. Actually, I'll save the top layer for last, because that's going to be a hassle. Now I'm running into similar problems. That means that there's a red and yellow piece. Goes on an edge. It's not in the right place. I have this red and yellow, but there aren't any more where that could go. So the hexagon is in the wrong place. It's an easier mistake than it is to go the other way around. Here's how I'm going to figure this. The side that I didn't move the centers around, each of these connects with one color. There's four colors, blue, yellow, red, and green. Each of these pentagon faces hits one of one and two of the other, two being one pentagon and one hexagon face. Each hexagon is mirrored diagonally. And going off of that, that means that I was right one of the first times around. But I still don't have the right piece for that. Oh wait, it flew over here. Okay, never mind. It's still wrong. I need to fix that before I go any further. One of those puzzles that doesn't really, I don't play with it that much just because how much time it takes to solve. And unfortunately I get into the habit of thinking, oh yeah, I'll get a difficult looking puzzle. We'll see how long it takes me to solve it. Well, once I solve it the first time, generally not much interest in solving it after that. So I don't get a lot of new puzzles just because I get disappointed with how quickly they solve. And I think the ones that I do get, like this one, I get kind of disappointed that I don't really solve it a whole bunch. But if I did, I'm sure I would know the color scheme a little bit better. What am I doing? I cannot talk while I assemble this, apparently. Of course, whenever I have people over, they always pick one of these up and scramble it, and they want to see me solve it. I've been lucky, for the most part, that they don't scramble the ones that came up with a solution years ago and forgot them. No. Just need the foot. Most difficult bits in. And that's it. Makes that easier. There we go. It It is a bit catchy. It always was before, even before this, so that's not something I'm worried about. That's part of what makes it take so long to solve, too. It took me about, I think, 3 days to find a solution, and then about 30 minutes after that, I never got any faster.